Okay, so as is tradition with a new major update, we have some improvements and visual stuff. This isn't the only dev blog, I believe, that they've released about visual things for War Thunder. It's a new major update, Firebirds, but this is the first one. So it says location improvements and updated abandoned factory. So let's take a closer look. The Firebirds major update brings with it a host of improvements to several locations and a complete graphics update to the abandoned factory ground battles map. So we can already see a picture here. Of course, Abandoned Factory is a classic War Thunder map at this point that pretty much has played any session you have. You're going to end up seeing this map at least 16 times. So I'm curious to see what they've done with it. It doesn't look like it's just a visual change, though. It looks like they have actually updated some of its environment itself. So let's see. Welcome to the updated Abandoned Factory map. One of the most beloved locations amongst players for ground battles has been completely transformed visually. Our artists have replaced all the soil textures with new, clear, and authentic ones, and the models and textures of buildings and almost all elements of the environment have been changed. Grass and small vegetation have been updated, making them denser, and bushes have been reduced in size to better match the size of ground vehicles. Despite being significantly updated in terms of visuals, the performance of the location has not changed much when using the same in-game graphic settings as before. So again, like, we've got scenes like this, you know, which this looks entirely new. At least the whole, I mean, you can see the puddles and stuff and the reflections. All of this is definitely not what Abandoned Factories looked like before. Abandoned Factory, singular. Of course, the everyone's favorite place to duke it out here, where I think the A point always is, up here, somewhere on the other side of this. This looks relatively similar, but you can again see how much the detail here has increased in the ground and the rubble and all that kind of stuff. But see, like, a lot of this looks new. Like, some of it looks like they've replaced the actual props, if you will, with entirely new ones, which is maybe exactly what they did. And then we've got another picture here. You can even see water leaking out of one of the pipes. That's kind of interesting, and forming a pool down below. The water looks great. The water in the mud and stuff, that looks pretty damn good. And then here we've got a shot of, I think, the south part of the map. Over there is where one of the spawn points is. This is right near one of the caps on the other side of the, where the camera's facing from. And then, of course, this, the spawn points on the far side. Like, this looks pretty good, you know, but I can still tell that we're in Abandoned Factory, you know. But moving on, we have improved effects. So, on Abandoned Factory and other War Thunder locations, dust clouds from tracks and wheels caused by ground vehicles in hot weather have been improved. When it's raining, you'll see realistic puddles and streams of water flowing from the roofs of buildings and the surface of objects. By the way, for Abandoned Factory, we've separately worked on the sky effects in cloudy weather, meaning the clouds have become more realistic. Bullshit. I will never believe the realistic cloud stuff after we were lied to about dynamic clouds. Okay, so we've got a video here that shows the rain on Abandoned Factory. Which, I mean, it looks like good rain. I'm not really sure what effect here is supposed to be new, because it just looks like the rain has looked, which has always been pretty good ever since they updated. I guess it's the pools on the ground, maybe, or something. And it sucks, too, that they say that you can see the rain, like, washing off of the roofs, but they don't actually show that. They show this, but you don't see it dripping off the roof, so I'm not really sure what's going on there. But now we also have this, push objects that were previously static. So the ability to interact with various objects in the game has also been updated. For example, in the new Abandoned Factory and other locations, you can now push carriages on the railroad tracks, giving you the chance to freely make your own passage or make it difficult for your opponents when driving into cars and trucks. They are realistically crushed under the tracks of your tank. So we see this little demonstration video here, and the first thing I want to take note of is actually pushing the train cars out of the way, which is probably, I don't necessarily know how realistic that is. The fact that this tank, which weighs quite a bit, is just knocking these two giant train cars like they're made of, well, plastic, but especially from the side when they should be locked in place on the railway. But aside from that, that is honestly not too bad, because it has always been frustrating in any map that has railroads with rail cars to be driving along and then you accidentally prick the corner of one of the rail cars and you stop dead in your tracks, you know? So now, even if you're not trying to push it out of the way, even if you just scrape it, you're not going to get stuck. It's going to push it a little bit, or, you know, push it with you or something. But what I do have to say that I think looks really cool is actually the crushing of the car. This part right here, where you can see it actually melt underneath the treads as the tank rolls over it, which that actually looked really cool, that effect. So that's neat. I think that's definitely a big ol' improvement. It's more or less eye candy than anything, but still. And then, of course, another thing that'll be important for aviation players, we have airfield overhauls. There's also great news for pilots. We've significantly improved all airfields for aircraft in test flights and missions for high-ranked aircraft. Well, sucks for everybody that doesn't play top-ranked jets. Again, low-tier players get fucked over. Or should I say mid-tier players, even. The runway slabs have been completely reworked, with the textures becoming sharper and the airfield environment improving significantly. There's new buildings, a reliable light signaling system, and positions for anti-aircraft missile systems for protecting aircraft. There's even aircraft skid marks to improve the airfields. We consulted with current pilots and think they've turned out pretty well. Now, it's possible that they will improve the lower tier stuff. I think I read somewhere that they said that they were going to do that. It's just that they started with the high tier stuff first, which, I mean, I don't know if that was or wasn't needed. I'm not going to say it wasn't needed, but obviously I don't play top tier jets enough to know how fucking shit the airfields were in that. So, but here we've got a few screenshots of the new airfields, which you can see. They're all very fancy and neat looking. Here we got one in a winter setting. You can even see little helipads. I have no idea if those are usable. I'm assuming they are, but not that it's really going to matter if this doesn't have helicopters on the map. So that's good for people that fly top tier. Hopefully we see similar improvements. I mean, we have seen improvements to airfields over the years, but it takes so long. It takes years for them to make any kind of update to them, you know? But that's that. So these are a collection of visual improvements. Now, it's not the only one, because there is also a dev blog on ray tracing for War Thunder, which that's going to be to talk about, but we'll get to it.